All right, let's do this. My name's Everett Minshall. I'm an aspiring machine learning engineer. And in today's video, I wanted to go over Blankley's LSTM model performance. You may have seen in a previous video, we covered Alpha Vantage's LSTM stock price prediction model. I thought I'd go ahead and share another LSTM model that I found through a group called Blankley. They are creating a pretty cool quant finance Python library package where you can do a lot of backtesting strategies and use Blankley's interface to easily get indicators such as the RSI, the MACD, as well as several others. Similar to AlphaVantage, they have a tutorial that allows how well it performs to say if it works any better than the AlphaVantage model. For those who may have not seen the previous video, the LSTM stands for long short-term model. An LSTM model is a recurrent neural network in artificial intelligence. It's really good for time series applications because, unlike other models in data science or machine learning, long short-term models are able to have recurrent feedback. Instead of data being fed through a model and it just keeps updating itself, a long short-term model is able to go back a couple of steps to see how it correlates to what it's being fed currently. There's probably some technical jargon I just said there that isn't quite right, but that's probably the best way I can explain it at the moment. What's really cool about an LSTM, you can think of it as having an attention span, and it's able to remember, sort of speak, with its neural network, things that happened previously, and it applies what's happened previously to its predictions for the future. This is something that's really popular in finance and stock predictions because of that. It's able to make those predictions based on what's happened before quantitatively much better than a human could. I think it's really cool that these companies are building these LSTM models and just giving it out for free for people to use. I'll link it in the description below, but I think let's go ahead and just jump into the code. Similar to the AlphaVantage video, I'm not going to dive super deep into the code because it is a lot and I don't want it to become like a 2-hour long video. I can link to the original, I think it was like a webcast or a webinar where I pulled this code from, but let's go ahead and see how it works. You can already see here the packages that we're going to need to import. So let's go ahead and do that. The first function is basically defining our episode generation and our X and Ys for our data arrays. The second one is called initNN, which is the neural network. These lines here are specific to Blankley. What's really cool is that Blankley connects to a trading platform like Alpaca or FTX. I know FTX is sort of in hot water right now, but anyway, they have a bunch of different markets that you can connect an API to. And the interface model and the state just allows Blankley to connect to that interface and pull data from. And then, of course, we're going to pass through a symbol here. This line just gets the closing price of the last 900 bars and returns it as a list. The other, I guess, value prop that Blankley offers is you can automatically calculate certain indicators like the RSI and the MACD by passing through, you know, its indicators method, and you can just store that data as RSI or MACD. So it automatically does that for you. There are other packages that do it. Blankley really focuses on bringing all the different types of packages that you would normally need to pull data, indicators, and to do backtesting. It all brings that into one package for you. So you can just learn the methods here and do it. which is pretty cool. It's taken me some time to learn, but it's definitely worth checking out if you're into quant finance. So we can sort of ignore this in the example given. They were doing Ethereum data for the 8-day episode, and they're going to try to predict the first 5 from those 8 days. So I changed it to 3. We're just going to try to predict the next 3 days of price based on the last 8 days of price closing. And the feature engineering is calculating the ratios of the day change given our indicators. So this, you can think of this as like the logic, the trading logic that we're going to use to decide, that the neural network is going to use to determine whether or not it's going to buy or sell. We have the RSI for the last 11 periods, and we pass that through, as well as the MACD, the values and the signals. And then here they've put it into an array. Here is the training loop, and it's a fairly small subset. So they're going to do a learning rate of 0.0003 and a number of epochs, it looks like 10,000. State LSTM. LSTM is just coming from the torch. Yeah, here we go. The torch, PyTorch. So this is the LSTM, the neural network that they're building in the model itself. The criterion is the mean squared error, as well as the optimizer. This stuff I'm not going to jump too deep into because this is requires a lot of background knowledge, and it's sort of outside the scope of this video. This is training the model on a certain number of data it's going to use to make the predictions and decide if its criteria is good enough. This function is called price LSTM. It passes through the price, the symbol, and the strategy state. You can think of strategy state as our, basically, just as it sounds, the strategy that we're going to be using to decide the trading logic of whether or not we're going to buy or sell. So we've trained the model, we've got the model going, and now we're going to actually put it to the test. And we've got our RSIs. This is the input, the MACD, the values and the signals that it, this is the MACD, the values and signals that it's going to be using to determine whether or not it's a good trading point or not. The MACD values and signals, which is going to help the LSTM model decide whether or not it's a good trade or not. Put that into a tensor to run the model. These are the predictions here. And we're going to print the price so we know what's going on, as you can see. And then we're going to run the data through the trained model and yada, yada, yada. This isn't any interesting to you. So this is kind of important. The average price increase is calculated by dividing the sum of the next day's predictions by the number of predictions for the next day. Here we're going to average the price for the next day's predictions. Now, the reason we do that is because, right, we need a way of choosing which prediction that we're going to use. We just sum them all together and divide them by the number of predictions that we have for that day. And then you can think of this as our trading logic: buy if the price average is above 1. So if that price average happens to be over 1, it's going to go to a buy. And else, if it's, you know, if the current value is greater than 0, we think it's going to decrease, then obviously we're going to either sell to the proportion, right? You can sort of play around with this portion of the code, but basically all of this here is our triggering of buying and selling. You can think of everything up here as getting the data, running it through, and actually like looking at the signals and deciding whether or not it's and making the predictions and whatnot for the last 3 days. And then exchange, you can see I'm connected the Alpaca API. A strategy is just basically what we've defined, the LSTM model. And then we're going to add a price event. We're going to add our strategy. We're going to look at IBM. Our resolution is 1 day, and in it is just our neural network here. And then we're going to do a backtest, and we're going to just call strategy.backtest over the next 5 years. And we're going to start out with $10,000. So let's go ahead and restart and run all. It will bring up a nice little bokeh graph, and we can see how we do. Okay, cool. So we are done here. Let's go ahead and check out the bokeh plot. And oh man, oh dude, it looks like really did not do too good. As you can see, this is our account value with no trades, and our account ended under that. So we definitely lost money throughout the duration of the, you know, 5 years that we were testing this thing. So it doesn't look like the LSTM model does very well, or at least the default model that Blankly provides. It's unfortunate. I mean, it does give you a lot of good value here. You can see IBM's trend here. I'm surprised, I didn't realize IBM shot up so much in 2008. I wonder if this is a data problem here. You can see around 2020, especially when the pandemic hit, things went really wonky and our LSTM model just could not account for it and it just dropped. I mean, it was below the account value anyway, so it's not like anything was going very well. So it looks like I lost about $600, you know, if I had been using this LSTM model since 2016 or so, I would be down about $600. Not good. I definitely would not use that. Curious though, I wonder what would happen if we switched to a different company. Okay, great. So this is the Apple results. And as you can see, the account value is much, much, much better. So if I had given 10,000 in 2008 and just let this LSTM model do its thing, today I'd be sitting at a pretty good number here. Let's see what this is. Yeah, it'd be up about just over $5,000. That's not bad. That's about $1,000 a year that I'm making from this model. Hey, not bad. I'll take it. A lot better than the IBM. That's sort of an interesting thought experiment there. I wonder why Apple works better than IBM. Something to look into. And hopefully you found this pretty interesting. I'll link everything in the description. And if you enjoyed this video, please let me know what you'd like me to look at next, especially if you want me to try out other models or backtest different strategies. I will do my best to do so. And until the next video, I'll see you then. Bye.